Okay, the bread has risen. This is part two of the whole wheat sandwich rolls. I have greased two cookie sheets and I'm rolling this out to be 16 inches long so we can cut it to 16 pieces. And that's what I'm doing right now. Almost. Sometimes gives me a problem. All right, we got 16 inches. I'll be honest with you. The best knife to cut this with is actually a butter knife or a surrogated knife. Shrunk, I'm gonna be upset. I'm doing this is to get a general idea of just how much each one is, and then the small I can take from the larger ones to the smaller ones. As they state, this is going to make 16. I got 3, 6, 7, 8. Of these. 16 is too much for what I need. This is when you start breaking pieces up trying to match them up. So everybody gets the same amount. Now what they want us to do, there it is. They want 16. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 might be more than enough for me. Cut into 16 equal pieces. Shape each piece into a small flat roll. I don't want 16 of these bloody things. Because I know they're going to rise. I'm not making little tiny ones. I'm making about 4 inches, 3.5 to 4 inches, palm size. Because I have those sandwiches I'm going to make, I know these are going to spread out. You can get it into a ball before you press it down. It'll be more in a circle. And they're about 3.5, 4 inches. That's the size I'm making because I know they're going to go and spread a bit. thought about making these into hamburger rolls, but
I think the hamburger rolls would be too much. They want to make little bitty ones like that, but I want bigger ones like that, so I'm making fewer and spreading them out more. You can also use these rolls if you're going to make a tuna fish sandwich or luncheon meat if you want to use these in place of it. I don't know how it would be on hamburgers because they're thinner, but they're known as sandwich rolls, you know. They think they want these to rise for 30 minutes. All right, so I'll cover them and do what they have to do. And I will see you in 30 minutes. Okay, preheat your oven to 350. And we're gonna prick them with a fork. That's what they want us to do. That we've done that, they want us to brush the tops with water and then we're going to dust them.
Remember that flour that I put to the side? Side and I put it in the bowl. Here it is. Now they want us to press these with it. Making these, now that I've dusted, I'll put with the flour that I use when I'm frying or something. I have it right here, so I'll just dump it in with it and then put this on the counter. It'll be ready when I'm ready for it. So we're going to wait for this oven to get up to 350, and we are going to bake them for 30 minutes. And they said they'll be lightly browned. What else? And they say transfer them to a wire rack to cool. And that's it. So that's how you make, well, I should show you when they're done. I'll be back when they're done. Okay, it's time to take the rolls out. Roll sandwiches. Oh my goodness, they came out beautiful. Make sandwiches with. Isn't that beautiful? So I guess if you wanted to use luncheon meats, that would work well. Egg salad with the whole wheat sandwich. And they're light. Feel the lightness as I'm handling them. They're really nice. They're a good thickness. So when you cut them, you see when you cut them in half, it'll be just right. Anyway, that's how you make whole wheat sandwich buns. Take care. Bye-bye.